All right, I've got Sabrina and Rob with me from Ficek Insurance. How's it going today, guys?
Good, how's it going with you?
You know, it's a Monday afternoon. I can't complain. The sun is shining, so it's a good day here.
Perfect.
Give me the elevator pitch on Ficek Insurance. If someone's not familiar with what you guys do, can you break it down for me?
We've been in business 35 years. We bought out Mr. Clark 35 years ago. We purchased him and two other agencies. We now have two locations in Brandon, first in Richmond, and Murray Auto Mall, 1550 Richmond Avenue. And you name her, we got her. If we don't got her, we'll get her. If we can't get her, you really don't need it.
There you go. I like that. Quality is obviously very important to you. How have you maintained that for your clientele during the pandemic?
Personal contact. We were one of the first offices to blow our doors open on May 4th with screens and masks. And we've kept the screens and masks, and we've kept our doors open. And we just welcome everybody to come in with a limit of two people per office at a time. And it's business as usual, just with those restrictions.
Yeah, we're sanitizing surfaces and having cleaners come in after hours as well.
Yes, I've got my bottle of sanitization stuff here somewhere. Where's my stuff here? Got my big bottle of wipes right here, just in case someone comes in. Got to be prepared here in the studio. One thing that I'm hesitant to look into for myself, even though everyone tells me I really need it, is tenant insurance. And it's something my landlords have mentioned a bunch of times. My parents have mentioned it, but I still don't have it yet. So why is having something like tenant insurance important, especially for someone like me? I'm a young guy. It's my first apartment on my own. Why would it be important for me?
There's a couple of reasons. One is that it's very easy to underestimate how much you have. And it's very easy to look at what you have and say, well, yeah, but that's my 10-year-old table that someone gave to me and it's not worth anything. But in the event of a fire and you have to replace everything, you have to go out and buy a new table. And you want to be able to do it fast. You want to be able to afford it. And if you're working all day and you have to just zip in and out, the insurance company just goes, okay, great. We're going to insure everything to new replacement costs. So then you don't have to worry about finding a 10-year-old table. You find a new one. And then you don't have to worry about finding hand-me-down clothes. You find new clothes. And it puts you back in that same position very quickly. As well, when you are a tenant, you have risk based on who else you might share a wall with. So if you're in an apartment building or if you're in a row house and there's people living next to you, a duplex, and you start a fire and there's some negligence on your part, they could sue you and say, hey, now you have to replace all my stuff too. And guess what? It has to be new. And so then that protects you there. As well, if you're ever planning on buying a home, you can buy your tenant's insurance now and keep it for a few years. And then when you buy a home a couple of years from now, you've already started accruing your claims-free discount. So then when it actually starts to cost a little bit more, you have a nice 10 or 15% discount.
Wow, a lot of things I definitely wouldn't have considered. I know this past summer I dealt with flooding because I'm in a basement apartment. So that was definitely a little unexpected, and probably tenant insurance could have helped me there a little bit. Just a little bit. I know that in the coming months, it's usually, you know, it's getting colder outside. People like to travel a little bit as well. Maybe they do a little bit of vacationing. So traveler's insurance is also something that people should be wary of this time of year, correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, more and more people are going to the West Coast this year rather than down south, even though some of them have properties in Arizona, Florida, etc. They're going to the coast. And your Manitoba Health doesn't necessarily cover everything outside of the province. So the travel insurance would top that up to the point where you're not out of pocket.
Perfect. Good to know, especially because, you know, I know my parents are doing a lot of traveling. I mean, they don't live in Manitoba, but if they were here, it would definitely be something I would get them to be considering. And I know they want to go to Arizona this year. So something hopefully they're looking into on their end. And finally, since it is getting colder here in Manitoba, roads getting icier, auto insurance is also a big one.
Yeah, we have, of course, AutoPack, not a problem. We'll get you licensed and on the road, plus your driver's license. Plus, we also have private auto, which gives you a reduced glass or comprehensive deductible you can reduce that down to as low as $50 to replace your glass or your windshield, or for vandalism or fire or theft. When that kicks in, people are extremely happy not to have $200 or $500 out of pocket. They pay the $50 and they get on the road again.
Perfect. Well, this has all been valuable information for me and hopefully for a lot of other people that tune into Star FM as well. I want to thank you guys for joining us, and hopefully we'll chat again soon, okay?
Thank you.
All right, enjoy the rest of your Monday.
Thank you.